Welcome to the lecture on Advanced Calculus and Numerical Methods. In my previous lectures, I discussed about the line integrals and how to find the work done by using the line integrals, and also about the Green's theorem, Stokes' theorem, Gauss' divergence theorem, and also about the flux, how to find the flux by using the formula of Gauss' divergence theorem. So in these lectures, I'm going to discuss few more examples related to the Green's theorem, Stokes' theorem, and Gauss' divergence theorem. Example here, I'm going to find the area of asteroid by using the Green's theorem. Find the area of the asteroid x is equal to a cos cube theta, y is equal to a sin cube theta by employing Green's theorem. So the asteroid is given by like this actually. Actually this is a figure for asteroid, and the formula for asteroid will be given by what? X power 2 by 3 plus y power 2 by 3 is equal to a power 2 by 3 is a formula for asteroid. So now to find the area of the asteroid by using Green's theorem, the formula for finding area in Green's theorem, we have double integral ds dy is equal to 1 by 2 into the integration over the region C xy x dy minus y dx. The total area of the asteroid is actually given by area is equal to 4 times of the area of the first quadrant. So now I'm going to apply the Green's theorem only for the first quadrant, and I'm going to multiply the same for 4 to get the complete area. So now I'm going to replace the formula, area formula here. So I'll be getting now area is equal to what? Area is equal to 4 times of 1 by 2 into integration over the region C x dy minus y dx. So now given x is equal to what? A cos cube theta, y is equal to a sin cube theta. So from this formula, we need dx and dy. So from this, I'm going to find the value of dx dy to convert dx dy in terms of d theta. So dx will be what? I'll be getting 3a cos square theta into minus sine theta d theta. Dy will be what? 3a sin square theta into cos theta d theta I'll be getting. So now if I replace all the equations in the area formula, I'll be getting what? Area is equal to 2 times of integration theta from 0 to 5 by 2 a cos cube theta 3a sin square theta cos theta d theta minus a sin cube theta 3a sin theta cos square theta d theta. On expanding this further, I'll be getting the constant 3a square outside will become 6a square here. Iteration 0 to pi by 2. Cos power 4 theta sin square theta. Sin power 4 theta cos square theta d theta, I got it. So I can take here sin square cos square common factor. I'll be getting area is equal to 6a square 0 to pi by 2 sin square theta cos square theta into sin square theta plus cos square theta d theta. And we know that sin square plus cos square will be 1. So if I replace 1 here, I'll be getting the equation like area is equal to 6a square 0 to pi by 2 sin square theta cos square theta d theta. So now to expand this one, I'm going to use this formula. So the formula of the form 0 to pi by 2 sin power m theta cos power n theta is equal to m minus 1 m minus 3 etc etc and so on, n minus 1 n minus 3 and so on, divided by m plus n minus 2 and so on into pi by 2. So this formula can be applicable only if the values of m and n are even. So now in this formula, in place of m and n, I'm going to replace 2, 2. I'm putting m is equal to 2, n is equal to 2 in this formula. So I'll be getting what? 6a square, 1 by 4, 1 by 2 into pi by 2, I got it. So on simplifying this further, I'll be getting the area will be equal to 3 pi a square by 2 square units for the given problem. One more example. Evaluate integration xy dx plus xy square dy by using Stokes' theorem, where c is a square in the xy plane with the vertices 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1 and 0, 1. So from the Stokes' theorem, we have the integration over the region C vector f dot dr is equal to double integration over the surfaces curl f dot n ds. So first thing is we have to find the value of f dot dr. So f dot dr will be what? Xy dx plus xy square dy only will get it. So now if I compare this one with xy dx plus xy square dy, if I want to represent this in terms of f dot dr, so what will be having? Xy I cap plus xy square j cap and dot with dr will be what? Dx I cap, dy j cap, dz k cap. So that easily I can find the value of the f vector to find the value of curl f. So now, once we got the value of f vector, I'm going to find the value of curl f. So curl f will be equal to what now? Ijk, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, with xy, xy square, 0. So suppose if I draw the figure for the given vertices, the figure will be like this here. So now, after expanding this curl F, I'll be getting the value of curl F is equal to what? I into 0 minus 0 minus j into 0 minus 0 plus k into y square minus x. I got it. So I got the value of curl F is equal to y square minus f. So if I want to find the value of curl F dot nds, I'll be getting curl F dot nds is equal to y square minus k dot dy dz I cap dz dx j cap plus dx dy k cap. So I'll be getting what? Since here dot is there, I'm multiplying only k with k. I'll be getting y square minus x dx dy. So now replace this value here in this equation along with the limits for x and y. X and y. So here x varies from where to where? X varies from 0 to 1. Y varies from 0 to 1. So now if I incorporate all these values, so I'll be getting the value of double integral curl f dot nds is equal to the integration x varies from minus 1 to plus 1. So from the figure, if I take the complete structure, the value of x varies from minus 1 to plus 1 and the value of y varies from minus 1 to plus 1. So if I replace all these values in this equation, the it will be equal to y square minus x dy dx. So first integrating with respect to y, I'll be getting integration of x from minus 1 to plus 1 y cube by 3 x minus xy with the limits minus 1 to plus 1 dx. After replacing the limit, I'll be getting x from minus 1 to plus 1 1 by 3 minus x minus of minus 1 by 3 plus x. I'll be getting into dx. On further simplification of this one, the limit will be x from minus 1 to plus 1 2 by 3 minus 2x into dx. So again integrating this one with respect to x, I'll be getting 2 by 3x minus 2 by 2 x square between the limit minus 1 to plus 1. After applying the limit and simplifying this, I'll be getting 2 by 3 minus 1 minus of minus 2 by 3 minus 1. The answer will be 4 by 3 I will get it. So hence the value of the integral by using Stokes theorem will be 4 by 3 here. One more example, evaluate double integral over the surface S xi plus yj plus zk dot nds, where S is the surface of the sphere, x square plus y square plus z square is equal to a square. So from the Gauss divergence theorem, we have the formula for double integral, that is f dot nds is equal to triple integral div f dot dv. So since here they are given sphere for sphere, so I'm using the Gauss divergence theorem to expand the sphere here. So now given f is equal to what? Xi plus yj plus zk. So I'm going to find the value of div f. So from the formula, we must have div f here. So div f is equal to what? I can write dou by dou x I cap plus dou by dou y j cap plus dou by dou z k cap dot with xi plus yj plus zk. On expanding this divergence, the answer will be 1 plus 1. This will be 3. So if I replace this 3 here, I'll be getting the value of the integral will be double integral f dot nds is equal to triple integral 3 dv. I'm going to replace this whole thing as some 3 times of the volume v. So where v is the volume of the sphere x square plus y square plus z square of radius a. So and also we know that the volume of the sphere is given by 4 pi a cube by 3. So now I'm going to replace this volume in the previous equation. So I'll be getting the double integral over the surface as vector f dot nds is equal to 3 times of 4 pi a cube by 3. This gets cancelled. The answer will be 4 pi a cube. One more example. Use Gauss divergence theorem to evaluate double integral over the surface S vector f dot nds. So where f is equal to x square minus z square I cap plus 2xy j cap plus y square plus z square k cap. So where S is the surface of the cube bounded by x is equal to 0, x is equal to 1. Y is equal to 0, y is equal to 1, z is equal to 0, z is equal to 1. It means that the value of the limit x varies from 0 to 1 here, y varies from 0 to 1, z varies from 0 to 1. So from the Gauss divergence theorem, in the sense we have to use this formula, that is double integral vector f dot nds is equal to triple integral v div f dv. So the first thing is we have to estimate the value of div f. So given f is equal to what? X square minus z square I cap plus 2xy j cap plus y square plus z square k cap. So if I found the value of div f, I'll be getting what? Dou by dou x I cap plus dou by dou y j cap plus dou by dou z k cap dot with x square minus y square I cap plus 2xy j cap plus y square plus z square k cap. So after expanding the divergence, I'll be getting what? Dou by dou x of x square minus y square plus dou by dou y of 2xy plus dou by dou z of y square plus z square. So after differentiating this one, I'll be getting 2x plus 2y plus 2z. 2x plus 2z. So answer will be 4x plus 2z I will be getting. So now I'm going to replace this value in the triple integral formula. So that, therefore, the double integral over the surface is vector f dot nds is equal to integration x from 0 to 1, y from 0 to 1, z from 0 to 1, 4x plus 2z into dz dy dx. On integrating with respect to z, I'll be getting integration x from 0 to 1, y from 0 to 1, 4xz plus 2z square by 2 between the limit 0 to 1 dy dx. After applying the limit, I'll be getting the equation like x from 0 to 1 and the integration y from 0 to 1, 4x plus 1 dy dx. So now integrating this one with respect to y, I'll be getting the equation like x from 0 to 1, 4x plus 1 into y between the limit 0 to 1 into dx. So after applying the limit again, the equation will be integration x from 0 to 1, 4x plus 1 into dx. So again integrating this one with respect to x, I'll be getting 4x square by 2 plus x between the limit 0 to 1. So after applying the limit, the answer will be 2 plus 1 minus 0, I will get it. So answer will be 3. So this is the required solution for the given problem by using the Gauss divergence theorem. Thank you.